Would you like to be intellectually regressed? Well, good news. Just listen to some traditional education apologists frame spending cuts and prepare for a deep dive into the dizzied, vague pseudo-logic of confused emo speak.
It is cruel, it is inhumane, and it is heartless.
Let me break it down for you. Cuts are bad. Increases are good. Like from Representative DeLauro from Connecticut.
A $9.2 billion cut to education. Millions of kids around this country are going to suffer what has been done with a $9.2 billion cut to our education programs, which is supposed to serve our youngsters, make sure they have a good future and a bright future.
Because budgets should always go higher every year, regardless of what was spent or even wasted last year. So how much was spent last year? Who cares? Cuts are mean. Here was a good one, Senator Elizabeth Warren's criterion for whether a federal program should be kept in existence. Wait for it. It's literally whether the name of the program sounds like a good thing.
They want to take away after-school programs, gone. Teacher training, gone. Class size reduction, gone.
Playful puppy program, gone. Cats playing piano program, gone. Let's say, I don't know, maybe if a $7 billion program were proved to be wasteful and just one federal education idea called maybe the School Improvement Grant or SIG program, and even if the very same administration that ran said program admitted it was a complete waste. Well, I guess cuts are still always bad. Mean cuts. You'll also get some shaming tactics and virtue signaling thrown in for good measure in the sense of those bad and mean cuts are being advocated by bad and mean people.
But what Betsy wants to do, what Ms. DeVos wants to do, and it's totally true, she has no connection to public schools. What she wants to do is actually just drain the public system of the dollars it desperately needs when half our kids are poor.
Betsy DeVos wants to drain money when kids are poor. She must be a mean cut lady, because budgets must always go higher.
When she says that she won't support making sure that you don't privatize things like special education and after school programs that are being cut.
You see this same fuzzy emo speak with respect to state education funding as well. People will say things like, isn't it terrible our state ranks near the bottom in education spending? And you'll see articles like this one. To exit last place in per pupil funding, Utah would need to spend $365 million more a year. Cue the hand-wringing, furrowed brows, worried expressions, and crocodile tears. You see, it doesn't take much brain power to realize, even in some theoretical teacher union fantasy world,
Xanadu,
there would still be states that spend less than others. To suggest that spending less than another state means you should spend more is just complete numerical gibberish. I mean, is this clear? If tomorrow every state literally multiplied their education spending by a billion, there would still be some states at the bottom of the per pupil spending ranking. The trouble is, this nonsense thinking is not rare. But here is the truth. Education is not in the federal constitution. The federal government's education role should be limited to Washington, D.C., military bases, and Native American reservations. And saying that cutting a federal education budget is automatically cruel or dumb, implying that, of course, those budgets should always go up every year, no matter how much was spent or wasted last year, is asking you to turn off your brain.